Circuit training as a method of training. We would advise that you get yourself an area in which you can move. Mrs. Sweetman is stood in a badminton court. So this is roughly the size of your lounge. So if you've got a coffee table, move it out of the way. And we're going to take you through the six different stations for your circuit. So our first station is going to be a squat. So feet are shoulder width apart, knees over toes, bend at the knees as if you are sitting down. Your second station is going to be plank to work your abdominals. So the easy version of this is what we call a high plank. So arms are straight and feet are shoulder width apart. To make this harder, you then bring your feet in together. And then the final variation, which is the hardest one, is whereby you will drop onto your elbows. So forearms are on the floor and feet together. Station number three is going to be press-ups. Now, Mrs. Sweetman is doing press-ups on her knees because we're going to concentrate on really working your tricep. We want to keep your technique good. So the easy variation for your press-up is hands that are going to be wider apart than your shoulders. You're aiming to go down under control and push straight back up is one repetition. To make it harder, you need to bring your hands in so they are narrower and underneath your shoulders. And again, repeat the same action, lowering down and coming back up. Whilst doing your press up, you do need to make sure that you're engaging your core so that you're nice and tight in the downwards and upwards phase. Station number four is lunges. So step forward onto your front foot, making sure the knee doesn't go over the toe, and sit back onto your lower leg. Now you're going to repeat this for 15 seconds on either leg. Station number five is going to be heel touches, and we're going to be working your abdominals and your obliques, which are the muscles that run down the side of your stomach. So first of all, you need to lift your shoulders slightly up and you're going to reach down with your hands, aiming to touch the back of your heel or of your trainers. Station number six is going to be the wall sit. So again, find yourself a position on the wall. Now you're aiming to make sure that your bottom is the same level as your knees. If you do need to make this easy, you can of course decrease the distance by shuffling up the wall a bit. Or if you did want to make it a little bit harder, you can sit further down into your wall sit.